Hey guys, so I know it has been a while and we'll get into that in another video. I'm wanting to start doing videos again, so I decided this is probably a good one to start with. I am currently putting together a large kind of pantry stock order with Walmart. Given the supply chain issues, I just kind of feel like it's probably a good time to go ahead and stock up on some items, including some canned stuff that I wouldn't normally get. We like fresh produce for the most part, and then a lot of frozen vegetables. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. And not like hoarding stocking, but given, a family of six and now seven with my mother-in-law, it's a good idea for me to do that. So that is what I'm doing right now. And I will share, it's gonna be pretty big. So I will share that with you after I get it picked up. Also, we got a little Chewini. Isn't she adorable? Oh, oh, sweet girl. So right now, with food and paper products, my order is $3.1927. Oh my gosh. But I mean, I guess it's better to be safe than sorry. All right, so this is everything I just picked up at Walmart. Primarily dry goods, stock up haul, like I talked about earlier. So I'll just kind of, and I don't remember what the cost was now. I think it was 340 something, but I said it earlier. So I did pick up some non-food items, got some toilet paper towels, and the little wipey things. So here we go. This is everything on the table, and I have a little bit more behind me on the counter. So I'll get to that. But this is the stuff we purchased. I'm not going to go through every single price because, it is just, to me, that's just, it's too much. So I picked up stuff that we use and some stuff that could substitute, for some fresh items should the need arise. So I did pick up three salsas. I got two containers of salt. And back here, I have a whole bunch of tomato sauce. You can see right there. A bunch of Rotel. And these are things we normally use a lot of anyway. I have a bunch of cans of green beans and canned corn. These are really the only vegetables that, I mean, I like them canned. other than that, not so much. I picked up some Jell-O. Really just to have, especially since I got, some canned fruit. Those are the flavors. I picked up some backup baking powder and baking soda. I picked up maple syrup. I'm sure that's not actually pure, but tastes better than like Mrs. Butterworth. So yeah, those two lines, like I said, are all green beans and corn. And I picked up canned mangoes. There are not very many canned fruits that I personally like, but canned diced tomatoes are one of them. If you've never had it, it is pretty good and pretty convenient to throw in like yogurt and stuff like that. Okay, so I have several cans of green chilies. I just realized that I was gonna get some olives. I think I forgot. Oh, a big thing of olive oil right here. So there's size perspective. It's pretty big. I picked up two bags of sweet potatoes. Those will last in your pantry for, seems like forever. All right. I picked up some steel-cut oats. That's not something we usually have, but I thought it looked kind of good, so I just kind of grabbed it anyway. Two boxes of cream of wheat and then a big container of oats. I want to say this. I do normally lean toward generic items, but I had a lot of substitutions. Oh, and back there I have just some regular russet potatoes. Okay, the other canned fruit that I like are pineapple chunks. And I don't just go off of what I like, but it's also kind of what my family likes. Probably because that's what I like, I guess. Don't normally buy canned potatoes, but I went ahead and did so. I bought several cans of those. I thought that would be pretty good in like a stir fry or doing like a mix of the new potatoes and vegetables again, should the need arise. Several cans of tuna. Okay, now we're getting into some other stuff. We do like stir fries and things of that nature around here. So I have several cans of water chestnuts. I have some hoisin sauce, sesame oil. Do have three little backups of, oops, garlic powder. All right. And then these little crunchy noodle things. So some of it's just kind of fun. It's not all like, oh my gosh, this is what we have to eat. Okay, so then we have some fire roasted tomatoes. And I got some French fried onions. I went ahead and got the good kind for Thanksgiving. So I'll set that aside for that. And these I just picked up because they're kind of a yummy topping on some stuff. They're not super healthy, but they're great in casseroles and, something just add a little crunch to some food. I was down to one backup bag of flour, so I'm gonna purchase two of those. And then I did quite a bit of pasta. I got six boxes of spaghetti. And underneath that is some of the thin spaghetti. I got six boxes of thin spaghetti, and I got linguine as well. So there's that. And now let's walk on over here to the rest of it. Okay, so I grabbed three bags of powdered sugar because I do like to make, cakes and things like that. And during the peak of the pandemic, when you could get nothing, it was hard to get things like powdered sugar and brown sugar and, some of those like fun foods, especially with kids, like some of those fun foods that kind of make, life a little more interesting. So, I got two packages of butter. I have been getting butter every time I go shopping, so I do have some already in the freezer because I have noticed that's one of the items, at least here, going up in price. I got three packages of brown sugar. I picked up just three bags of different stir-fry vegetables, and I picked up some frozen chicken breasts. I ordered the 10-pound bag, but I substitute 2 5-pound bags. If you're shopping at Walmart right now, at least here, these frozen breasts are now cheaper than the fresh ones. So there's that. I picked up some red potatoes. I have a bunch of roasts in the freezer from when Gerb's, which is our Kroger, had buy one get one sale. So, and then over here, I just grabbed some chicken thighs for tonight's dinner. So there we go, guys. That's everything we have. So our pantry is like super stocked, I feel like, for me, super stocked. Oh no, that's just gray. I thought there was something in my hair. So let me know in the comments, have you guys done some extra stocking, like knowing that there's like the supply chain issue going on, or are you just totally not worried about it? So just let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching.